That Sydney Olympics, you got the gold. You stayed on that boat, and you also had one of the biggest highlights of your career. So this past Sunday marked the
Hit the game winning
20th.
shot?
No, you didn't. Marked
What
the
happened?
22nd anniversary of your iconic dunk at the 2000 Sydney Olympics.
Yes.
The basketball community very much feels that this was the greatest dunk of
Your
all time.
ability, V, your ability to downplay, like, your ability to downplay some of the greatest moments in not just basketball, but sports history is incredible.
Bro.
Like, I'm sitting here, like, we
When she
was,
was talking,
Roz,
I
we
was
was.
literally thinking about the game-winning shot
Yeah, but Roz,
versus
that's
the
what I'm
wing. My
saying.
bad.
Like, Roz, we were sitting on sideline in a preseason game, and I'm like in awe. Obviously, most of us think like the 2000 dunk contest is like probably the best dunk contest ever. He, Vince, most people believe had the best performance ever. And I'm sitting here, like, really thinking to myself, man, everything I've been wanting to ask him, I'm doing it. I talked his head off for the whole game. We sat and talked an entire preseason football game. Do you know how boring and long a preseason football game is? We talked literally until the clock ticked zero. I said, listen, I don't know where this relationship is going, so I'm going to ask it now.
You might not see him again. You got to get it
I
all
didn't
out.
know. I didn't know. His ability to downplay some of the greatest moments in sports history is incredible.
He's
He
so
talking
humble.
about, oh, you talking about that. Yes, that.
Yes.
Why are we going over the anniversary of something if it's just that? No, it's not just that.
I mean,
No. Okay.
This past Sunday marked the 22nd anniversary of that dunk.
Incredible.
What
Incredible.
can you still
20.
like can you
That
still
thing is
remember?
20. That dunk is 22 years old.
Yeah.
First of all, it's legal.
Yeah.
Bruh. That's a long time. Like, there's kids like
Legal and iconic.
it's I don't know, man. I still to this day, the one thing I always say is like, how come none of my teammates at the time it happened or right after it happened, as you would now after a crazy dunk, the reaction, they never said a word to me during that play. They never said anything to me. So after it happened, the celebration, whatever, with KG and I to play defense, it was a timeout. I remember sitting in the timeout and just everybody just looking at me and just like, shaking their head. I'm like, all right, cool. Because I didn't still didn't know. I didn't find out till after the game of what happened. So they're looking at me like, bro, you good? But meanwhile, I'm like, all right, it was a dunk. And ooh and ah, cool. Until after the game, I'll never forget Gary Payton's guy on a little camera, the new little small little camcorder. He's showing me, and I'm like, wait, run that back. Run that back again. So I watched it seven times. So this is like literally off the court before I walked into the locker room. Then I'm like, oh, wait a minute. I jumped over him. They're like, yes. Such and such.
Yes,
Such and
you
such.
did.
You did. I was like, wait. But because all I remember, I promised the guy, I remember my forearm hitting him because I got the steal, so I'm trying to get to the rim before, he's 7'2" before he blocks it. So I'm trying to get up before him. For different guys, it's just different approach. This gonna sound weird. Just work with me.
Accidental freakish hops. Yeah, that's what
Right.
that
It was
was.
just, if a guy who looks like he's my height or whatever, I take my time. But like a bigger guy, I want to get up first. The Mutombos, if you look back at those dunks, I'm trying to get up before these bigger guys, because of the contact. They hit you way up there. It's a longer fall for me than them. So I got up first. And I just remember the contact. I'm worried about the rim. I tell the story all the time. I'm focused on the rim and making sure I make it because I thought I jumped too far. So that was my focus. So that's what I was celebrating. I wasn't celebrating that I just jumped over this man because I didn't know. KG was celebrating that. I'm celebrating that I didn't get hung and I made the dunk.
Wow.
So it just made for a cool moment. And, sidebar, I'm glad. I subconsciously knew KG was there, so that's why my
Man,
celebration
hey,
kind of went
listen.
up. That's it didn't go forward as it normally would do. I kind of knew he was there. As I think about it right now, but yeah, if I didn't see him, yeah, I could have cold cocked my boy.